So now I have not much time for the stopping, so I can bring to us the last present of the day is Katerina Podolskaya, I think is how it is, your name.
Hello.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Hello.
So the presentation is Open Geodata and Open Source GIS in the Center of the Forest Ecology and the Productivity of the Russian Academy of Science with Ekaterina Podolskaya. So Ekaterina, the stage is yours for the last presentation of the academic room in this morning.
Hello, everybody. So it's very nice to to have this great opportunity to talk about something similar to open geodata and open source GIS. So is it okay with my voice and picture? Yeah. So, you see my plan, some kind of introduction. Our main topic for today is how we use open data and open source software for transport modeling. Something about our data and research possibilities. Forest infrastructure, comparison of data sources on the transport infrastructure, and QGIS plugins. We did some investigation, we did some research about the plugins and found something interesting for the forest management. So also I will cover some educational and publishing activities and conclusions, references, publications and some papers. So, open data and open source in the forestry. Introduction. So, open data. Is it okay with my voice? Sorry. It's okay?
It's okay. We can hear, at least in you, okay, and see the slides. Okay.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. Yeah. So, we are here to talk about open data and open source tools, GIS tools in particular. And I present today the Center for Forest Ecology and Productivity. It's a specific organization of the Russian Academy of Sciences, and we deal with ecology productivity for the Russian forest. So, ecosystem functions, resources, environment, problems, potential of Russian forest are our main occupation, for the research. So, we know that forest fires and forest resources are quite specific in Russian forest. So, and in particular, open data and open source tools have a great potential for the forest industry and their forest challenges in our country. So, in terms of organization and our activity, we have a specific transportation task, transportation group. There we deal with OpenStreetMap, OSM, and QGIS with its plugins, of course. So we are doing some publicity about open data and open source for geo-applications, some kind of masterclass, webinars, and publishing papers. Some specific features of forestry. Forestry is an industry. Reproduction, protection, regulation, and accounting of different forest resources. So, we collect open data, collected, maintained, and published by, of course, first of all, by regional administrations and some special divisions of forest agencies in Russia. And of course, they have quite great importance. They're really of great necessity for the forest departments nowadays. So some words about Russian Forest Code of 2006, official document, official regulation for the forest industry and forest management in Russia. So it's in fact a legal base for all the activities we are doing nowadays related to the forests. My three topics for today about research, educational and publishing activities, publishing directions in our center are transport modeling, CO2 emission, if we are talking about some heavy transport, and of course, I will conclude with education and papers. So, just a few words of introduction about transport modeling. Transport modeling, transportation accessibility, and infrastructure planning, transport planning, all these terms, all these topics, they are about how to navigate our heavy vehicle, how to find the best accessible route. So transport modeling connects, in fact, many research activities and practical directions in open source and in the commercial domain, of course. A good thing about transport modeling is that there are some teams, multinational, and they are dealing with many disciplines, and they present their results in GIS forms. Mason, Ibish, and Weiss, all these papers are quite recent. Transport infrastructure is quite complicated. There are different traveling modes. We can do prognosis in time and space. And one more thing about data services. People, our clients, internal and external, they prefer to use data services instead of data. So everything here is about open data and open source development. Some words about our specific features and our topic of research in particular. We have a database of ground access routes for the forest fires and forest resources for some region, for some regions of Russia. In fact, the main regions for us are regions in Siberia. And their main characteristics is constant annual fire activity. As attributes, we calculated time, speed, and length. So, and for this database, a volume of carbon dioxide, CO2, as transport emission could be a kind of special characteristic, additional characteristic to be used for environmental or economic research. And of course, it could be useful for some summary for the regions. For the small regions, for the federal districts in different scale of Russia. Here's a link to the paper. In fact, it was done in Russia and then translated to English. So, first map in my presentation, forest infrastructure and forest resources. Here we have a collection of fire stations in small black triangles, and fire stations, in fact, is one of the good example of forest infrastructure. So it's Novosibirsk region in Siberian federal district, and we calculate. We have some presentation here. Forest types are detected from MODIS satellite with resolution about 230 meters. So, our methodology ground access routes to the forest resources, and classification in hours. We used archive of data for 2002-2019 for Novosibirsk region. And here on the left you have scenario barriers, and on the right you have no barrier scenarios. There we have calculated time of access from the fire chemical station to the forest resources. So, great thing about these two maps is that we can calculate transport emission of CO2 as additional parameter for access route. One more map, which name is Ground Transport Accessibility of Forest Resources. It's a result, again, barrier scenario on the left and no barriers on the right, is classification in hours, and transport emission of CO2 is additional parameter to characterize the accessibility, transport accessibility of forest resources. So, one more thing we did, and we still in progress of doing a comparison for some region, is a comparison of data sources of on transport infrastructure. Of course, we know everybody that transport infrastructure is not constant, is not stable. And we can compare OSM data, OpenStreetMap data, to other data data sets. So, this is a link to our poster publication we did last year in Potsdam. And I add one more map, example of comparison, just to give you an idea how different would be data set from the legend. You see roads OSM data set from July 2021 compared to the public roads geo database of scale 1 to 200,000. So it's a kind of comparison, and again from the forest infrastructure we use for reference fire chemical stations. So, about QGIS plugins, open source plugins we use. We did analysis this summer with keywords like forestry, and found some quite modest, for the moment, quite modest set of plugins, active fire data from Australia, North Australia, Manager, a Fire Hunter, not a lot, in fact, plugins, you know, there are a lot of plugins, about 1,500 plugins nowadays in the collection of QGIS plugins, and only four updated and not experimental in terms of their status. So, open data and open source developments for the CO2 transport emission. Just two examples, open data, a big project data on CO2 and greenhouse gas emission, and project wine, usually it's air or Python package for the vehicle emissions inventories. Just two examples. So, one more thing, which is in fact very useful for us, is QGIS plugin, Road Emission Calculator. And this calculator could be very useful for us, for our transport modeling, for our research, because we can implement and we can merge our polylines, our access routes to some information and calculate road emission, calculate emissions by using road emission calculator. So it's in our plans. So a few words about education concerning education. Yeah. We are doing some workshops and webinars for internal use, and they are available online. QGIS is a direction. QGIS is the subject of implementation for different researchers for desktop and for server. So this is example of my publication, my small book published in Russian last year. Okay. Key areas, in fact, they are quite different. Krasnoyarsk, Irkutsk, Novosibirsk, they are all in Siberia. They represent the Siberian Federal District. And of course, we have some key areas in the center of Russia, different parts of the country, depending on the research projects and different collaborations. In conclusion, I was trying to summarize everything we are doing in terms of science, in terms of research and education. So, and for the moment, we link transport infrastructure, CO2 emissions of heavy transport, heavy forest trucks, forestry as a domain, as a direction, as a science, and geoinformation methods and technology. So, we have a collection of access routes, ground access routes for Siberia, and we have we can use them for environment research. Ecological and infrastructural assessment of ways to access the forest fires and forest resources is quite actual. It's a real need for forest industry in Russia. And in addition, and just to highlight the importance of interdisciplinary research, starting from February this year, we have a new working group here in the center. And we named Mapping Ecosystem Services of Forest. So, and my three last slides with references. First of all, projects. Then second one, some links covering transport emissions, projects. And then our publications. Thank you for your attention, and I'm here to have your question.
Okay, Katrina, thanks for your presentation. We have, yes, some questions. Here, below on the screen. So, what data is needed for a good analysis for wildfire response? I think the question is most for use in this plugin. What is data is needed?
Mm-hmm. The most obvious thing is updated data, and of course, OpenStreet databases should be updated. For some regions, remote regions of Russia, they are quite old. For some regions, they have quite good quality. So it's not the same for every region of Russia. Quite different, yeah. So. We have some collection of data, data sets here, internal use. So it should be good. It should be kind of summary collection, accumulation of everything we can collect. Yeah.
Okay. The next is: has the plugin testing in notice regions of the world susceptible to birds?
Mm-hmm.
I think here in Brazil now we need most this plugin to management better the burns areas here in Brazil.
My kind of my start of research was to find any plugins, any plugins related more or less to the forest industry. Yeah. So then I need to investigate, and maybe next time I will show you some results.
Okay, I think the last question is, I think yes, but I need to make this question.
Of course,
is the plugin code available to consultation? Mm-hmm. It's on GitHub, no?
Of course, all the plugins are available. So you have a big collection of plugins, qgisplugins.com, and you can use it.
Okay, let me see if you have another questions in your room. So not for now, but Katrina, we have some minutes. I want to know if you have some to share your contacts or invite the people to know more about your job, your working.
Just a moment. Screen. Just to show you the contacts.
Okay. I can share you address and mail in the chat room.
Yeah. Too. In fact, the main link is this one, transport modeling. We have our website is in Russian and in English. We have both versions. And you can consult it anytime. Yeah.
I can put this link in the presentation now for the presence. And I want to say thank you for the presentation. It's a very good, I think it's a great job to work in the burning area, like here in Brazil, Pantanal or Amazon area. We need a lot of work of the use the plugin. So Ekaterina, I say thank you for your presentation. Thank you for being here and share if with us. And I want to show in the social gathering and around the map of the Buenos Aires. And I say thank you. Thank you a lot.
Yeah, thank you for your time. Thank you, everybody.
Bye. Bye. So I think we can reach your schedule in this morning. So I hope see you soon in social gathering. Walking around the Buenos Aires virtual map. And don't forget that we have your gala dinner today. So make your present in this events, parallel events in the FOSS4GIS. So thank you for your time, and I see you soon in social gathering. Bye.